All right, adventurers, welcome to Altplay. We're here with more of Dr. Boom's The Boomsday Project Puzzle Lab. We're on the second challenge of the survival wing. Let's get started.
You want to see the big guns? Look no further.
All right, Boom Master Flark, let's do this. Oh, let's do this. All right, again, we're doing survival, where the goal is to survive the boss's hero power.
I am the master of boom! The boom master!
Okay, so the hero power...
pales in comparison to the raw destructive power I possess!
The hero power is the same. I want to...
fireworks, that is. I'm not making bombs or anything. Promise.
I want to heal to full health. In order to survive the experiment, they're going to deal 29 points of damage, so I need 30 health. Okay, Boom Master Flark has got a much bigger board. Okay, his side of the field from left to right, we have the Booty Bay Bodyguard, a 5-4 with Taunt, and we have the Hoarding Dragon, a 5-6 with Death Rattle. Give your opponent 2 coins. The dragon's been damaged for 4 points, so it's really a 5-2. Our side of the board... we have Auction Master Beardo, a 3-4 that says, after you cast a spell, refresh your hero power. And the Deranged Doctor, an 8-8 that reads Death Rattle. An 8-8 that reads Death Rattle, restore 8 health to your hero. The Doctor's been damaged for 5, so it's really an 8-3. All right, I knew they were going to let armor be a thing. We're a priest at 1 health. Our hero ability is Restore 2 Health, and there's no cards in either of our decks. My hand from left to right, Topsy Turvy, swap a minion's attack and health, flash heal, restore 5 health, 2 copies of that. We have Lie of the Nairu, restore 3 health. If the target is still damaged, summon a Light Warden. We have the Voodoo Doctor, 2-1 with Battle Cry, restore 2 health. Shadow Word Pain, destroy a minion with 3 or less attack. And Maiden of the Lake, your hero power costs 1. Okay.
Can I light the fuse yet? No? How about now?
Okay, I think I want to drop Maiden of the Lake so I can use my hero power over and over.
I am freed from the curse.
All right. Now with Auction Master Beardo, we'll be able to use our hero ability over and over. We just have to play spells so the Lady of the Lake and Beardo do their thing. Let's see. If we lose our Deranged Doctor, we're going to get 8 health. I also want the dragon to die. I want to kill the dragon, but we got our taunt in the way. So let's get started. Deranged Doctor can attack. He can attack. He's going to attack the bodyguard. So they both die. We heal for 8. If I use my hero ability... I almost did out of order. If I use my hero ability first and then play Topsy Turvy on the dragon, we'll be able to use it again. Thanks to Beardo. Now we can use it once and kill the dragon with Shadow Word Pain. It's a spell, so we're going to be able to use it again thanks to Beardo. And let's do just that. Right? Yeah, let's do that. Now we can coin it up. It's a spell, so it's going to flip our hero ability over, but I think we're done with that. If I drop both of these healing flash heals on me, I'm going to be down to 1 mana. I'm going to be down to 1 mana, but I'll have 25 health. Dang, I think I shouldn't have. Let's see. Let's go for it. So now we can coin it up. Yeah, we're only gonna make 28. Dang it.
In the light's name.
Dang it. Let's see, what'd I do out of order? Because even if I would have been able to play
If I would have been able to play
both of these, I still would have been at the same amount of health. So let's see what I do. What I do out of order. What I do out of order. Do I want to play the main of the lake? I don't know that I want to heal that many times, to be honest. Let's attack here. I should have counted how many times I healed. I think I did it twice, meaning I only paid for one, really. I don't think that's worth playing the Lady of the Lake. Let me try it without the lady. If I heal, then I drop topsy-turvy here. Now I heal. And I kill him. That's two coins. If I use this again, I'm at 15. And that's three. I heal, that's 20. I drop a coin. Ooh. Yeah. I can't use the hero ability. I gotta drop a coin. If I play Flash Heal. Yeah, if I drop the coin, there we go. Okay. I wasn't supposed to play the Lady of the Lake.
In the light's name.
So now if I play the Voodoo Doctor, we made full health. That's just what I was thinking. Playing the Maiden of the Lake wasn't worth it. It actually cost more. Oh, this is going to be good. This is going to be good. We got a lot of my favorite tools here. Okay. Flark side of the board from left to right. He actually has two copies of the Haunted Creeper, a 1-2 that says Death Rattle, summon 2/1/1 Spectral Spiders. And in between those, he has a Mulch Muncher, an 8-8 with Rush. Costs one less for each friendly treant that died this game. And then on our side of the board, we have two copies of the 1-1 Wisp. We are Druid, which means we have our hero power of +1 attack this turn, +1 armor. And then we also have 1 health. Nothing in either of our decks. Nothing in either of our decks.
Oh. You blow up 3 lousy intones and suddenly there's safety regulations.
Our hand from left to right, we have 2 copies of the 1-1 Wisp. Then we have Floop's Glorious Gloop. Whenever a minion this turn dies, gain 1 mana crystal this turn only. Then we have the Witchwood Apple. Add 3 treants. Add 3 2/2 treants to your hand. Then we have Whispering Woods. Summon a 1/1 Wisp for each card in your hand. Then we have Poison Seeds. Destroy all minions and summon 2/2 treants to replace them. We have 2 copies of Poison Seeds. And we have the final card, one of my favorites, Tree of Life. Restore all characters to full health. Obviously, that's the card to play, but it's 9 mana, and we only have 2. So let's make our way there. Let's drop the Wisps, because they're free. Then we can play Floop's Glorious Gloop. Whenever a minion dies this turn, gain 1 mana crystal this turn only. All right. So now we can go ahead and kill our Wisps. We can specifically send them both at the same Haunted Creeper. Whenever a minion dies. Okay. So we just killed 3 minions, 2 of our Wisps, and 1 of their spiders. So now we have the 1 mana left over, and then we have 3 extra, so we're at 4. summon a 1/1 wisp for each card in your hand. They won't be able to attack, though. If we play Poison Seeds right now, we're actually going to get six. We're going to get six Treants in play, which means we're going to get six mana. Let's do that. All right. Now, if we do it again, we'll have two mana left over, and we'll kill, what, eight minions? Because one of the big spiders was still there. If we do it again, we'll get eight mana, putting us at 10. And then we got the Tree of Life. Perfect. Tree of Life plus Arcanine Soul Priest. My favorite. All right, Flark side of the board this time. He has the Turret Sentinel, a 4/8 with, after your opponent plays a minion, attack it. Then Death Rattle, refresh all mana crystals. Okay. Our side of the board, we have the Flying Machine, a 1/4 with Wind Fury, which means it can attack twice. There's no cards in either of our decks, and we are a paladin with one health, and our hero power is summon a 1/1 Silverhand Recruit. Our hand from left to right. We have Forbidden Healing. Spend all your mana. Restore twice that much health. Then Glowtron, a 1/3 with Magnetic, which means we can play this to the left of another mech to fuse them together. We have the Steel Rager, a 5/1 with Rush.
You blow up three intones and suddenly there's safety regulations.
A 5/1 mech with Rush. Then we have the Blessed Champion, which reads double a minion's attack. And Ziliax, a 3/2 mech with Magnetic, Divine Shield, Taunt, Lifesteal, and Rush. Oh, this is going to be good. Okay. After your opponent plays a minion, attack it. I wonder if that counts with the Magnetic ones. Because clearly we're not just going to attack with the Flying Machine. Clearly we're going to put some mechs together. Question is which mechs. Also, we have 10 mana. So let's see. When this dies, refresh all mana crystals. Okay. So in the event that we kill this, we need to have spent as much mana as possible. If I play Ziliax to the left of this, they're going to merge together. It's going to be a 5/5 with Wind Fury, with Divine Shield, Taunt, Lifesteal, and Rush. Neither of them will die. This one will lose its shield, so it's not even going to take damage.
Unity. Precision.
I did my numbers wrong. What was it? It was a 1/4 and a 3/2. Oh, yeah, I did do the numbers wrong. Is that a 5/5? It's a 4/6. Okay, that's fine. Whatever. Didn't change anything. I guess if it has lifesteal, I guess I want to get this as big as possible. Or maybe attack once as big as possible without killing this. And then make it as big as possible and then kill it. Or I spend all my mana. I get to 10, spend all my mana, kill this. And then drop Forbidden Healing. Maybe that's a thing. Actually, I think I see something already. Double the attack. Double attack would be 8. That'll put me at 9. That's not gonna work. So let's play this. Bring those together. Oh no! Isn't that a mech? Are we still a mech? We're still a mech, though. Wait a second. Excuse me? So, wait. Oh, does he not have magnetic anymore? Oh, he doesn't have magnetic anymore. You can't merge more than one mech? Or did they just take it because he's got so much shit on him? Wait, wait, no. Oh, he doesn't have magnetic. Oh, okay. Okay. That changes things. That changes things. Okay. I got to play this game a little bit differently now. Let's go back. Okay.
Yeah, I agree. Needed more gunpowder anyways.
Okay, so he's not a magnetic mech. This is, and this is. Okay. So let's drop this here.
Converting stored energy.
This here.
Unity. Precision. Perfection.
I don't know why I did all that. So if we attack here, we're going to gain 5 health, putting us at 6. Okay, take it back.
If you're not ready, just give us a signal. You got all the time in the world.
Okay, let me see something now. I put that there. That has 4. I needed to get another point somehow. I need to make 9. I need to make 9 before I kill this thing. Wait, no, I don't. I don't need to make 9. I need to make 7. I need to make 7 because this is Wind Fury.
Yeah, I just want to blow stuff up.
I need to make 7 because this is Wind Fury, so I can attack it twice. Okay.
Unity, precision, perfection.
Actually, I don't even need to make 7. I need to make 4. Because I can attack it twice. Oh, that's going to put me a 9. I think I should have played this first. Actually. Shoot. This one's... I get what I need to do. I need to attack this twice before I kill it. Or the second hit needs to kill it. So what if I do this? And then we double it. Now we attack it. That dies. I get all my mana back. Now if I spend this, I'm going to get 20 health. Okay, there we go. My favorite ability to abuse is Wind Fury, or my favorite mechanic to abuse. That's why I'm like, I get it.
How will you survive? I'm on the edge of my seat.
That's why I was like, I get it. I just can't put the pieces in order. Okay. Flark's side of the board, a 0-2 target dummy with taunt. Our side of the board, we have a 1-1 microbot. It's a mech. We're a paladin with 1 health. Our hero ability is summon 1-1 silver hand recruit. There's no cards in either of our decks. And my hand from left to right. The battery pack, refresh all your mana crystals. Forbidden healing, spend all your mana, restore twice that much health. Glowtron, a 1-3 mech with magnetic. Steel Rager, a 5-1 mech with rush. Blessed Champion, double minions attack. And Ziliax, a 3-2 mech with magnetic, divine shield, taunt, lifesteal, and rush.
You're gonna survive this. Oh, wait. We're on Outland.
Okay. So we want to make this sucker as big as possible this time. We just want to go head first. We want to make this guy as big as possible, and then battery pack and forbidden healing will do the rest. This is 20 points right here, so we really just need to make it to 10. This is 20, so we need to make it to, actually, this is 20, so we just need 9. We really just need 9 somewhere. Here's 3. Ooh. How about if I put you two clowns together? That's 8. That there would be 9. That's 8, and I still got 1 point left. How about that? Actually, let's put all you jokers together. Oh, I can't. I can't.
Where's a fuse that's normally going off by now?
That there.
Unity. Precision. Perfection.
And we'll put you in the mix.
Converting stored energy.
All right, so that's 9 points. We get attack here. He has lifesteal, so we're going to gain 9 life. That brings us to 10. Then I can drop battery pack and forbidden healing on myself. There we go. All right. Flark's side of the board. He has 2 copies of the turret sentinel. Remember, that's the 4/8 that reads, after your opponent plays a minion, attack it, and death rattle, refresh all mana crystals. Again, 2 copies. Our side of the board, nothing. We're a shaman with 1 health, and it looks like our hero ability's been used, but it's summon a random totem. No cards in either of our decks. And my hand from left to right, Forked Lightning, deal 2 damage to 2 random enemy minions with overload 1. Murmuring Elemental, a 1/1 that reads battle cry. Your next battle cry triggers twice this turn. Lava Burst, deal 5 damage and overload for 2. Healing Wave, restore 7 health. Reveal a minion from each deck. If yours costs more, restore 14 health instead. Then we have...
Where's a fuse that's normally going off by now? I miss it.
Then we have Refreshment Vendor, a 3/5 that reads battle cry. Restore 4 health to each hero. And Antique Healbot, a 3/3 mech that reads battle cry. Restore 8 health to your hero. Then Shudderwalk, a 6/6 that reads battle cry, repeat all battle cries from cards you played this game. Targets chosen randomly. Okay, all battle cries. So that's really just these. I'm sorry, that's actually Murmuring Elemental. And then the Refreshment Vendor and the Antique Healbot. Interesting. Interesting. Okay. So ultimately, we have 30 mana. We have 10. And then if we can kill both of these the right way, we get 10 more from each. We can't kill them both at the same time. We've got to kill one, spend the mana, and then the other.
Yeah, I just want to blow stuff up.
Shudderwalk is obviously the last piece if we play it. That's if we play it. Remember, we're only trying to get it 30 health. We're not trying to get 30 mana. We're trying to get it 30 health. Okay. So maybe Murmuring Elemental. Ooh, he's going to eat. Oh, okay. I think I see it. I think I see it. We need to play the small ones so that one of them dies. Let's see. That's 1, 3, and 3 is 7. That's actually not enough to kill either one of them, but I'm going to assume this one. This one will be on 1 health. So then we can drop Forked Lightning, kill this one, and finally start damaging this one. We'll be out of mana. Oh, actually, we won't even be out of mana.
Roth, are you gonna survive this?
If I drop,
wait, we're on Outland.
Murmuring Elemental, he's gonna go to 7. I drop the heal bot, I'm gonna get 16 health. He's gonna go to 7. He's gonna go to 4. I have 3 mana left. Shoot, this one's tricky. Okay, this one's tricky, but I think I can figure it out. I'm pretty sure I can figure this one out. Murmuring Elemental, so my next battle cry is gonna go twice. He's going to attack and kill it. Yep. Now I need the same one. I'm going to assume it's going to go left or right. If this one attacks and the thing survives, this one will attack next. That's what I'm assuming. This will heal me for 16. Now if I play Lava Burst, this is going to die. And I'll get all my mana back. Yep. Okay. What if I play this now? Oh, shoot. I can't play Forked Lightning. I need to play Forked Lightning. I can only play this if there's at least two enemy minions. Okay. What if I don't need it? Yeah, I need it, don't I? Actually, I don't think I do. I might not need it. If I'm at 17 health and I play Refreshment Vendor, that's going to put me at 21. Ooh, no, but then I can't play Shutterwalk. Yeah, I need to play. I need to play Fort Lightning while there's two minions, two enemy minions. Okay.
This is one long fuse.
So let's go ahead and get that out of the way, though. Since I have to play that before one of them dies, let's go ahead and play that right at the start. Now, Murmuring Elemental. So what if instead of Antique Healbot, I play Refreshment Vendor, which is only going to heal me for 8. But that's fine because that's still enough mana to do everything that I tried doing last time.
Funnel cakes. Get your funnel cakes here.
Ooh, unless I was supposed to... No, I wasn't. I was going to say unless I was supposed to... Did he survive? He survived the first hit. Oh, okay. Unless I was supposed to lava burst and then get... That's not how it works. Let's lava burst the bigger one. The one with more health. Okay. So now I heal myself for 7. If I antique heal bot, I'm going to go up to 24. They're both going to die. And I'm going to get all that mana back. Now, if I play Shutterwalk, all the battle cries before are going to happen again. So we're going to, my next battle cry is going to go twice, not the ones that are happening. And then I'm going to get 4 mana back. I'm sorry, 4 health, and then 8 health. I'm going to be well above 30.
My jaws that bite, my claws that catch.
Yeah. All right, so Flark side of the board. This time we have the Turret Sentinel once again. The 4/8 that says after your opponent plays a minion, attack it, then Death Rattle, refresh all mana crystals. Then we have the Corrupted Healbot, a 6/6 that reads Death Rattle, restore 8 health to the enemy hero. We are a shaman with 1 health, and our hero ability was used, but it's summon a random totem. In our hand, from left to right, we have 2 copies of Ancestral Spirit. Give a minion Death Rattle, resummon this minion. Then reincarnate, destroy a minion, and restore it to life with full health. Then we have Rockbiter Weapon. Give a friendly character +3 attack this turn. Then we have Ziliax, the 3/2 mech with magnetic, divine shield, taunt, lifesteal, and rush. We have Unbeaker Lightning, deal 8 damage to all minions. And Moat Lurker, Battle Cry, destroy a minion, Death Rattle, resummon it. We have 10 mana. Okay. So we're going to need to abuse a lot of things here. I can already see it. Okay, so if we play... Let's see, what is this? 8 to enemy hero. Okay. This is our easy kill spell here. But we're going to need to find a way to kill. Oh, this one's messy. This one's messy. I don't like it. Okay, this one having magnetic doesn't matter because we have no other mechs. We have no other mechs. So we're not merging stuff together.
Can I light the fuse yet? No? How about now?
This one's messy. This one's a messy puzzle. Okay. Let's try stuff. How about that? Let's just try some stuff. I can kind of see that I want to give Ziliax the Rockbiter weapon. I kind of see that. Okay. Let's give... I feel like I also want to give him a copy of Ancestral Spirit. Since he has Rush, if he dies, we can attack with him. If he dies and he has Ancestral Spirit on him, we can attack with him. Let's try this out. Because this is a lot of mana. This is 12, 17, 2, 17, and 8 is 25. That's a lot of mana. So we're going to need to kill this twice. So let's Ancestral Spirit that. Okay. If I destroy this and bring it back with reincarnate. Ooh, not yet. I can't do that yet. I'm trying to not play these two because I still got a lot of mana that I can use. But I think I need to go Ziliax.
Unity, precision, perfection.
Oh, shoot. I forgot he's going to attack it. I completely forgot he's going to attack it. Okay. So if I... I don't like this anymore. I don't like this anymore. Oh, shoot. So if we kill him by hand, if we kill him with reincarnate, there's actually going to be two, and then they're going to start eating everything. I don't think I like this puzzle anymore. If I give him the rock biter weapon, we just got to attack.
Primitive.
So we get all that mana back. Do I hit him with Ancestral Spirit again? And then play Moat Lurker killing him? How is this going to get me to... Oh. How is all this going to get me to... to 30 health. Okay, I probably should play Reincarnate. No, Ancestral Spirit here. I think that was the key. If I can kill him three times, that'd put me at what I need. That's probably what I need to be doing. Now play this. Eat him. He attacks here. He dies, so we get another one. Yeah, that's the trick. And then I got to drop Unbeaker Lightning. So if I play Reincarnate now on this, he's going to die. We'll get all our crystals back. And then we can play Unbeaker Lightning, killing both of these. So that's what, 8 each? 16? Yeah. Ooh, I got lucky here. I got lucky on this one. I cannot deny that. I cannot deny that one. I realized too late. I realized too late, or just like one move early, that I was not doing what I was supposed to be doing. All right. Another challenge within the survival wing. Done. Okay, guys, if you enjoyed this video and would love to see more, then all you have to do is hit that red button below this video, as a subscribe button, and turn on notifications. That way you get notified whenever a video gets posted to the channel or whenever we do something special like Dr. Boom's The Boomsday Project Puzzle Lab. Thank you guys for checking this out, and I'll catch you later with more here on Outplay.